Hello, everybody. Welcome to how our DPS tank in. My brother, sadly, he had to go to work around this, that, but I'm pretty sure I can get him. So, guys, this is how our DPS. We're gonna do something a little different. We are doing the Burden of the Father first. What that means is that usually says something right there, down there. 90-minute time limit. You get to attain the weekly reward that says on all of these. I'm doing them like this. And there we go. Alexander queues up pretty fast. You're gonna make sure that you're going with a full party. It usually queues up like that, half part, small, you know, party, light party, then full party. This is Alexander fight. That's the last boss. Wanna do? Gear up for it. Always be nice to these people. This is gonna be my group for this entire ops. There's another monk in here. And he's not full of gear. DPS him from the back, guys. Stick to the back. This guy's gotta go fast. Each leg's gotta go fast. Once you get down in the middle, well, you're not gonna wanna stop doing this. You're not gonna wanna stop DPSing this. Once you see everybody gather to the side, that little head charge up. You're gonna have to leave. Cause that thing can give you one hit. Yeah, I said one hit. And bam, I get scooped up. And where's the tank that's scooped up with me? There we go. We just DPS the stall down real quick. Cause if we don't, it's over with. He's not gonna be a very friendly doll. Once it's over with, it's over with. You wanna charge up real fast and get back to where you were at. You don't wanna waste time. Like I said, do him from the back. He's down to 10%. This ledge goes down, we're gonna have to change. We're gonna have to get in front of him. And I said, do not stop. Stop. Oh, you did. Don't worry about your health or anything. He gets down to a third of his health. We're all gonna move to the front. We're gonna get some type of shielding put around us, hopefully. Like right about now. Get all good together. Pop that. That way almost nothing's done. Nothing. No power. Now this is gonna be the tricky one because once this one goes down, before this one goes down, there's gonna be these lasers that are coming out. See that laser? And if somebody's got more than one of them, stay like a healer or whatever, stay away from them if you can. Because if you don't, you're dead. You are dead. And I'm gonna do all the Alexanders, so I'm just doing the last one first. Yep, I said last one first. Reason being, it needs to be done. These dogs need to go down. Take that from somebody. Don't want the healers to get hit by this. By those lasers. They do focus on the lasers. It does focus on the healers. Don't let them say that it's random. It's not always random. They will focus on the healer. After this leg goes down, I got scooped up again. This is gonna happen. Burning fast. You're not always going to be the first one in here with the same tank, but thus far it's been the same tank. So that's what you want to do. You want to burn this thing fast. And once it's burned, it's going to spit you right back out. In my opinion, they put the most, the ones that are doing the most damage, the tank that's doing the most damage, and the healer that's doing, and the DPS is doing the most damage. You want to rush for that head. Always take that head out. Always go for the shoulder tackle if you got it. If you don't got the shoulder tackle, don't worry about it. Use another one. But get there fast. Because this thing's got to go down quick. Because if it don't, it can all go to hell. Yeah, I know. I'm doing Dragon Tick in the back and whatnot. Ooh, you want to get front for this. Because this is going to be the power hit. This is going to take everything damage. See that? If your healers aren't quick on that, then you guys are going to take damage. A lot of it. There are some healers that do pop the shielding that will protect you somewhat, not fully, but somewhat. Others just pop that heal. And if you can pop that, not that, no. Let me do that. I got knocked out. I have. If it was quick enough, she'll catch it. If not, then you're out. Always ask nicely, Red, you. Sometimes I don't catch it. But I've been took out one a few times. They gotta be getting away from the healers quick though. Get away from the healers quick because of that thing. She's smart. And if you can, do your best to help around the healers if you can. If you can use your ability, your second wind, that helps healers out a lot. Stay away from those AoEs. Do not get hit by the AoEs because they can do a ton of damage and they don't look like they do it. They're not always going to be the one attacking from the back, but for God's sake, people, do not attack from the front. Do not attack from the front unless you're a tank, because that's the only person supposed to be in the front. You can aggro. Music's pretty cool too, so if you guys got time, look one of these fights up where these people got the fight up, and you listen to music. Me on the hand, I don't mind it. I just want to get this fight over with, you know? Because this is one of the roughest fights. He's at 9%. We might have this. Yeah, I know it's a bunch of repetitive movements. Crap. He's down to 2%. I'm not gonna pop it. I'm gonna let somebody else do it. There we go. He's over. I'm gonna give it to one of the healers. Because she did pretty good. She did pretty sweet. Vote for everything. Need on everything. You have a chance of getting something, or if not, nothing. And that's not what you want. You don't want to get nothing, because that means you have to res this again. And I got nothing. So. You want to get something in all these things, and all the Alexander fights. And yes, you want to do them one after another. So stay near a repair mender or whatever. A merchant mender or whatever. Stay near one during the Alexander fights. That way, You can get in, get in, get in, get in, get out. Don't leave a merchant mender. Do not leave the side of one until you're done with them. I made the mistake of queuing up before I was near one. So, yeah. Don't leave the side of one. Sorry about the little skip in time, guys. I don't know what happened. It's not my internet. I'm as close to my internet as Ngee without being completely hooked up to it, so I don't know what. So, that could be a result. Like I said, don't leave the side of a mender. And do all your hard Alexanders first. Make sure you clear your selection so you won't gear up for that again. I do it 3-2-1-4-3-2-1 if you guys are asking. That's the how I do it. That's just me. I mean, a lot of other people do it differently. Alexander's, yeah, this Alexander just queued up for is not the most popular. It's not, so it may take me a few minutes to queue up, hopefully not too long. Because I don't like spending too much time in the Alexanders. I'd like to keep the Alexanders rolling. But the third one is a pain in the butt. That's that jellyfish one, I think it is. No, yeah, it's a jellyfish one. That's the pain in the butt. Because that's the one he can wipe you off the stage. He can knock you off the stage if you're not quick enough. Next one is the real hard one, because if nobody knows what they're doing, you can really literally get wiped. I always eat something in this one. I always eat something in all of them, but this one's the main one you want to eat. And we have another monk with the same dress as I got. Ah, great. I hate these copycats. Pisses me off. Bullshit. The tank's trying to pull everything at once. Try to pull it all together. That'd be a good thing and a bad thing. And this group's not very strong. Not like the last group. I'm pretty sure we could have burned these guys down with nobody's business. Last go around. I get hit by this thing too. So in other words, stay at its side. That's going down pretty quick. I got some pretty okay DPS. Yeah, this dude kind of mimics me, but he's what you call it. He ain't got the same gloves as me, which I'm glad, at least. I got the entire outfit. He seems to have doesn't, so at least it's not a complete mockery. And he's not in the same... He's not in the same what-you-call-it as I am. Fairy, so I ain't gotta worry about a mock. Mocking monk. Alright, this is getting real good music. And you want to stay away from this guy. You want to get in this guy's face and stay away from these. If at all possible. So stay behind this guy that he released Turner on Turner a little too early, in my opinion. He did it way too early. It looks like he's mimicking what I'm doing too. I'm gonna wait to release the turn release until I know I'm gonna do a lot of damage to him. Get away from me, dude! Go! See? Pointless, useless monks don't know when to freaking stop. Made me lose Grease Lightning too. I'm hoping you'll pull him in the middle. Don't hit him right there. Don't get... See, this is the stupidity of it all. Come on, get out. See, a lot of people get in front of this guy, but they're taking damage they don't need to be taking. Yeah, this isn't gonna go well. This is not gonna go well. This is some of these tank fakes. They pull them in different directions. I know they can't do that, but they can do that, but the thing is that it's not the smartest thing in the world. Pull them completely in two different directions, like all the way over here, all the way over there. Alright, this is the hard part, guys. You gotta burn these little things fast. See this little old thing? Burn them fast. Get them down fast. Alright. Best to have some people on one side and another group on the other side. And if you can, if you're a tank, pull some of these things together. Burn this guy the fastest. Do not let things hit the floor, hit the ground. And if you're positive and positive, get together. Negative and negative, same thing. Get together. As long as they're the same thing, get together. If they're positive and negative, separate. If you don't, you're going to have done a ton of damage done. Some people should still stay on one side. That's positive, negative, separate, separate, separate. Still stuck. Damn it. Last thing you want to happen. If you can, this group gets together. Pop Manta. A lot of monks don't use what I use, like the two things I just did. That helps out your parry, that you take less damage. You parry a certain amount of damage. Okay? Now he is gonna do that switch up again, turn of that hand, and as soon as his wife becomes 100% percentage. Okay, you wanna move away from everybody when these things happen. Just that. That's an AoE that can hurt everybody. You don't want that. You wanna move away when you get an AoE surrounding you. Come on, this boss is a pain in the butt because of the damage he can do. And his annoying AoE. As I said, I'm not taking any senseless damage. See? he slams on the ground again, and we're all near that edge where that one monk is behind him. He's gonna get knocked back. He's gonna get knocked back. You want to be near him, not right underneath him, but close enough where you do damage. Now that monk's attacking that one. I'm not gonna take the same one he's attacking. I all got the same amount of life. You only can burn him down to a certain percentage, so don't think either hand is gonna go down any faster than the other. They won't. See? As soon as that happens, bam, he goes back. As soon as he loses a certain percentage of life, he goes back. And then this happens again. And you gotta burn those old things again. Do it fast. Stun them if you can. Buzzing negative, stay away, stay away, stay away. I'll get pulled in still. Perfect. Stay away from people. If you pop Manta, pop Manta. People may ask, why are you not doing the limit break? Well, 3 does better than 2. 3 is stronger than 2. Alright, this is gonna be a rough one. Dammit, you fucking healer! Apparently some people don't know that you're supposed to stay close to one another when you have positive. Don't do that! Hello. Like I said, it doesn't matter what you get if you're not really. I'm not really aiming for it. Aiming to getting anything too much. Because I got a lot of my gear already. Good, I got something. Okay, that's cool. Alright, next up is the one that I'm going to show you that's a pain in the butt if you don't know how to work the mechanics. This one was straight up just AoE heavy. Not really a big deal, but it was a pain in the butt. And you want to make sure, like I said, stay near a merchant mender. That way you can get these things over with quick. Pretty sure the Adder's Nest has one. But yeah, after this, I'll be cutting live stream and I'll be heading off after these last two. Not before. But like I said, I hate this. Yeah, I thought it was going to have one that doesn't. So I'll have to warp somewhere where I know it does. But you always want to queue up for something before you do anything else. Especially an Alexander. Because you don't want to get with the scrubs. There are some scrubs in here. Scrubs are being people or people that don't know how to do the what we just did really, really quickly. They know how to do it, but they're slow. They're slow on the uptake, and I've wiped a few times in Alexander's because of scrubs. And you don't want to get in the scrubs, so don't do it later in the week. Do it on redo day, on a reboot. I like to call it reboot. Basically, when everybody does everything at once, and all the good players are doing it because they want to get it over with, and the scrubs wait till the end of the week. Or Monday, and you don't want to do it then. Yeah, I know I didn't take much damage, but still, it is an Alexander. And the next one coming up is the second Alexander you do, and it is a pain in the butt. You do it in this order, you avoid the scrubs. Because all the heavy hitters are going to be doing the last one first. Because they want to get it up in the out of the way. They want to hurry up, be quick about it. I know I might not get many views on these, but this is how DPS is doing how I am doing the Alexanders. And this is how me and my friend Victor do the Alexanders when he's able to. Hopefully next week I'll get into the Alexanders with me if you guys want to see that. I mean, I'll be more than happy to get you guys to do that with him. So you guys can hear a healer's point of view on what's going on. And for you ass and others, not going to be a lot of cussing going on. This is going to be a clean one, and so is the next one. I'm going to probably do one every other week. Just, I know this is a little aggravating. But you do this. Nothing, I didn't sell nothing. That's good. Sometimes that's good. Let's see if I sold it. I did. That's a good beauty of having two retainers. Don't always want to do that. I know some of you guys don't like how some of these females are dressed. I for instance, don't mind it. I mean, sometimes they do take the male dress and put it on the female. Sometimes they just strip women, making them look like that, almost. But, I mean, come on, the woman with the open chest, they got a male version, and he has, I mean, he looks like a man whore. To be all honesty, he does. And the woman is like, at least she's got something covering her boobs. The guy's just got an open chest there, and I'm like, and parts are missing, and I'm like, how is that even, why would a guy even want to wear that? If you guys are interested in what I'm wearing, why I said that monk was a copycat. This is the monk gear. This is the smuggler's design. I like the smuggler's design. I just like the colors. It's light tone colors, you know. But this is what I have on. In my opinion, the 200 gear for the monks is lacking in any detail worth mentioning. Pretty much screwed up. And yeah, I know this is kind of my setup. And there we go. On to the next Alexander, guys. And then to the last one. And then I'll be off. Out of your way. Out of your hair. As you can see, it's 8:11. It's almost 9 o'clock. We had a big update. I don't know what it's about. I know, well, actually, I do know what it's about. We're supposed to get another 20-man raid. And yes, if anybody... Okay. Not cool. First time tanking this, not cool. That's exactly what you want. I mean, yeah, you don't want the tanks being the first time tanking this. And do not stand in front of those gates, because you will get murked quick. These goblins are, should be, no, not, should be easy. I mean, the better you are, right? Doesn't go that way. The strong you are, yeah, you're going to take out things quicker. But as a monk, you want visible over dex. A ninja takes dex over physical. They do more physical damage. Do more dex damage. Long range weapons like those tricking throws and whatnot. Yeah, guys, you might want to pull that back here. That's why you don't want an experienced tank in this area. One of the reasons you don't want an inexperienced tank. Because of that right there. I mean, she was all the way back there and they went straight for a healer. I mean, yeah, they're going to do that. If they're let loose, if there's nobody tanking. Tank is a good, is the best, is one of the hardest roles to do. Actually, well, hardest, I'd say easiest, because all they gotta do is keep things hitting them and keep them tracking them. That ain't hard at all. The reason I don't do them is because I don't like doing roles like that. Which, if everybody dies, yeah, she squishes. That paladin squishes. She gives the V-Pods a lot of the problems. Like, the healer is getting attacked. And for God's sake, guys, if you are a tank and you are tanking, going to tank Alexander, watch the videos on how to tank Alexander. There's plenty of them. They're mostly out there for tanks. As you guys just saw, there are some tanks that don't know how to tank Alexander, and then say it's my first time. Don't walk in there and say it's my first time tanking this, and not say, oh yeah, by the way, I watched the video. Watch the video. There's a reason you watch the video. The reason why the videos are out there is the most important. This is a DPS point of view, though. Not a tanky point of view. I'm doing this for the DPS is to show you what you guys got to throw through as DPS, what you guys got to dodge. Now, this does have some really good music. Now, a lot of these healers have what they call emergency deployment. Alright, nice. There it goes. It's the second Alexander. Yeah, it's just a bunch of goblins that will just wait for it. These little boys are out of the room. There's a few more of these out of the room. There's gonna be enough. Because if people don't know how to work those things, we're screwed. And it can't kill you. Can all die. We can all wipe. We get there's a lot of mayhem going on, isn't it? A lot of doing this, a lot of doing that. As a small DPS, you want to focus on the main problem. That being this position being the doll. I'll zoom out so you can all see the entire battlefield. Yeah, somebody needs to get in that god machine. Person is more experienced should be driving this thing. Okay, Lord Caster is going for him. Let's see why that's crucial. Real quick. That dude is not what needs to go first. This little machine over here is what needs to go first. The bomb? Yeah, his job is to pull that far away from us as possible. Because if not, that can cause a wipe. Alright, these are the problem. Yes, there is a back of these. See this little area right here? This is the back. That's not good. What the fuck is she doing? See, that's an experienced tank. She doesn't know what to do. Nobody is that she didn't watch the videos. That could get us all killed. That could cause a wipe. Watch videos, learn what to tank. Crap! Good thing we got somebody good on the god machine. Alright, he's about to go down. Couple of moments ago. Alright. God machine. There we go. That doll's the main focus, guys. Focus on the dolls. So the explosion, yeah, that could have caused a lot of havoc. Don't want to be there. Dogs can do a lot of damage. I underestimated them one time, I got took out. Don't underestimate the power of those dolls. They can one shot. I don't know how strong the power is supposed to be, how strong they are without 200 gear, but they nearly one shot at me with 200. The 200 gear that I got on now. Before I had some 190. Now, if they'll do it now or not, I don't know. Pop. crap. Bomb. 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 Yeah, he wasn't paying attention, was he? What are you pulling this? What are you doing? Now you get your job. Now you're doing your job. Even inexperienced people can be inexperienced. Prime example right there. All right. You know what, you do not want to tank just one guy on this one. You want to make sure that thing gets took out right there before that. Explosions keep happening. Dude, there's a bomb right in front of you. What the fuck? Yeah, explosion lowers your thing to fire. And that means you do more fire, does more damage to you, but only for a few seconds. It's a vulnerability type thing. Alright, take him out. Take out all the ads first. Anything else. That way we can all focus on the ball. Next is just a straight up boss fight. It's not really complicated. It's the easiest thing to do. After these guys. Here's the boss. Thing is, there's dolls. And the dolls are the problem. They can do a ton of damage, like I said. Do not want this thing focusing on you to discontinue just like it's a beast. Tank in one hit. Why don't we have a freaking tank that's focusing that it's got? Think about having an inexperienced tank knocked down. And that's the thing about not having any experienced tank. That's not gonna help. You ain't strong enough. Took out a doll though. I got a healer back here. And I got another healer. I don't know, the other healer's down. Can I get a res, please? I don't need these things, so I'm gonna pass. Player commendation, the one that got me. Because at least she was paying attention. Now this thing right there, that little corner, that means you died and you got 1 minute. Hoping I get something, because if I don't want to do this one again. And who? Nobody. Bro. I didn't get it. I am not doing that. This happens. This happened twice, and I'm not about to do this one again because of that. Right there. That bullcrap. Inexperience. I don't feel like I do not want to do that one again. That's the roughest one out of all of them to do more than once. Because you get in there with the inexperienced tank, and you could just run these things all week and not get a freaking thing. And that's what's the pain in the butt, is that you can run them all week and not get nothing. It's best to wait until that sickness wears off. But I want to get these done. I don't care if I get anything. I really don't need anything. I'm really working on my 200 gear. But yeah, you don't want to have to worry about that too much. Always eat something before you go in there. Something like a grilled dodo steak or something that can up your skill speed, vitality, and accuracy will go up by 2. Basically, that's that stuff right there. Oh, this right here. And my strength was at 900. I don't know why it's back down the way it was. Back down the that low. But I'm going to reskill myself when I get off here. Because that should be 900 attack and all that. Strength should be at 900. I don't know why it's not. Currency. Yeah. I got a while to go before I can get up my level. In my adders. Be like that, guys. I'm not cutting the stream, I'm just gonna open some windows. PlayStation cam, so yeah, I might get one of those in the future. But for right now, I'm good. Probably sorry for the cutting thing broadcast. Again, I had to check something. My controller looks like it's gonna go dead, so I'm gonna plug this baby up. Charge it. Looks like an alchemist. Little mage here. Both of them Lalafels. Kind of cute. Little archer. Yes, for the elves, the bows are like huge, but for the humans, the bows are like huge. But alright, here we go. The last Alexander of the day. I'm not doing the second one again, because that one's just a pain in the rear. If you don't get nothing, you can continue to do them if you want to. I'm not about to continue to do them, because I got a life I want to live, you know? It's 8:30. I mean, to be honest, guys, there's no sense of running them back to back to back to back. Just get something small. When you probably already got what half you need. And there wasn't really anything that I needed that I couldn't get next time I do it. So, this is the first time Xander is a straight up boss fight. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Just a straight up boss fight. Ads, there's just one, that's the thing, there's one or two bosses, I'm not sure. But yeah, this is can do damage to you. That steam can do damage. Everybody's gonna get by. Might as well brace yourself. It's the boss. And this boss after him. I'm gonna do this. Get everybody. Burning. Burning with everything you got. I'm gonna wait till 3 before I hit the big time. Then it's gonna be a ton of damage. And then after I pop, I'm gonna be. Probably saw a pretty big number pop up there. That's because I used them all at once. I didn't waste any time. I popped off of some abilities. I wanted to decide the one I couldn't do, and that was how it was. I was going to cover, but it's almost there, so next time I need it, I'll add it. Come on, other tank. Where you at? That other tank shouldn't be taking that much damage. The best thing is one tank to aggro all the adds over to one side. One area over there or over there. That's the best ideological place to put them. I've seen a lot of tanks do that, which it works because there's one healer that can focus on Earth, not the entire group. And sometimes it's good to put up a healer, sometimes it's not. Because look at that add attacking that healer. Best to, I got there it goes. There we go, I got it. Down. The tank's buggy. The healers are dead. There, down. Now we gotta wait for the healers to get back here. You are not pressing forward, you idiot. No healers. We will buggy white. You guys better fucking wait for the fucking healers. And they're not. This dude splits in two. Yes, I said in two. There will be no mercy shown. See, now we're waiting on the fucking healers when we should have waited the healers beforehand. That dude's got an interesting look. Kind of funky looking. Like the little Lalafell tank. That was funny. Alright. Let's do this. Stay behind this joker. Once you flip, there ain't gonna be nothing. There ain't gonna be no time to be worried about which one's going at. Go on the one you focus on. Don't worry about any other. Got to be hit by this thing. That's the one hit. Like I said, if you are a tank, keep these things facing one way. I know that laser thing's impossible, dude. You can't tank that. But don't get hit by anything unnecessarily. Lift track, as a tank or as a DPS. If you can't avoid it like that, you can't do nothing about it. It's not going to do that much damage anyway. You ain't got that much longer. And don't get hit by any BOAs if you can handle it. And don't get hit by that, because burst things do damage, and I think they stun you. I'm not sure. I've never been hit. But try your best not to get hit by that. Don't let it hit to the fucking head. On the first Alexander I did, there is the second round. Act like a healer's guy, Cootie. If you're a tank, mark them. And tell them, don't go near the second round. If you do, you're going to get some type of virus. You're going to wipe it. How is that? And they'll blast off and form to get up. Oh, great. Someone's gonna have to take that kill. Because that bomb can kill them. That's the bomb. That bomb can hurt them. They do damage if you get these two focused on each other. Each other, one another. And that these people that don't, but I've seen them happen. I've seen it be damaged. You want to take one of these away from here, away from everybody. They don't usually have that much life. See? It did a little bit of damage. Not a lot. Always prepare to heal at that point if you're a healer. Okay, get away, get away, get away. Get away. And you don't want to be hit by that. See? No, whichever side person, one you choose at this point, you go ahead and choose. But they stay stuck together like that, that little thing feeding each other. I always go with the one with the one tank on it, because she's gonna, he needs somebody DPSing it too. Can't just have all one on one person. I prefer to go with the tank now. Gonna have one healer on him. I know he's gonna have a healer. Someone doesn't take that hit over there where he's standing, then they kill him. Because it's white. The thing goes at that type of life. You don't want anything on that healer over there. Keep it safe, because healers are what we need. Like I said, that thing can do damage to the thing, but the thing killed its own buddy. That lady. So alright, blast off. You do get hit by the exhaust, don't worry about it. Where all the intersections go. Where they intersect. Not want those things going near each other because they just get smashed. Yes, it does matter if you guys are doing your rotations on these things like I told you before. Alright. Okay. Blame them up for the raid decision. See, they're blaming me now because I'm a monk, and that's why the DPS is blaming me. It happens. You get jerked like that. I just took a freaking hit from you jackasses. Don't tell me fucking crazy gets close to me. Could not just DPS at all and just let you guys all die, just let you guys go. See, sometimes people don't like monks because they think we suck. And you can't have just straight up just non-mute. You can't have just magic user DPS. I've seen that go bad. My brother Victor said, oh, I was in a raid with two, count on two, DPS is none of them none of them melee. And it was back. They were both archers. Well, at this point in time, not hard, but you know what I'm saying. They're both ranged DPS, and that went wrong. That went horribly wrong. Because they don't know how to that you can't DPS like that. Blame anything on a DPS, that DPS is just pissed off and just let you fucking life. Let you guys suck and he just reap the reward. I've been in a group with a freaking healer that didn't do nothing and she still got the reward out of it. So yeah. Don't ever knock one of your DPS. Get the fuck out of my face. I just ended that motherfucker. Not the fucking tank. So yeah, don't underestimate a freaking melee DPS. That will piss somebody. And you all just fucking wipe because your own fucking fault. Yeah, blame the freaking, yeah, blame the DPS, huh? Yeah, now we're at a freaking light party, because a freaking healer left. Yeah, a healer left, guys. Now you think about that. All that stuff should have been brought up beforehand. This tank's just now thinking about it now. I'm gonna screw up. Dragoon, you wanna get kicked now? I'm triggered. Ah, I can't believe this. I might be on till 9 o'clock. Limit break. They're telling them to limit break. They're telling the Dragoon to limit break. taking the floor. I did. I'm going through the conversation. Letting you guys see this, that they're telling the Dragoon to limit break. He doesn't. And then... I'm gonna get to where they're blaming the monk. Me. Saying the deep... I'm out... pissing the monk our raid DPS is low. You're out DPSing me? Really? You're a laugh. What you get, guys, a bunch of jackasses that think they can outbeat that think they're better than you are. Already down to 80%, that's good. 85, no, only it would go this smoothly before. And if he's got 400 gear, then yeah, he's out DPS. Okay, that wasn't smart. Get these guys separated, dude. The only reason he was DLPPSing me is because he was fighting something else and he had a bunch more DPS in his body. I was just me doing it, so yeah. For running around like a fucking psychopath. Yeah, that dude needs to be red. This is going bad. The other way. We need our tanks. Where's our fucking tank? Res the tank. We're dead. Shut up! Yeah, I'm with him. Abandoned. Yeah, that Veil Knight, dude, you just been outed. Yeah, that ain't no sense of that bullshit going on. Wiping like that, and him and the constant, oh, I'm out DPSing you. Focused on out DPSing somebody, you're a bunch of fucking bullshit, man. Bull. You ain't even focused on fighting, you're just focused on who you can out DPS. What type of idiot is that, man? I'm gonna out DPS you. Well, I don't care about your out DPSing anything. Alright, I'm gonna try that one more time. I really don't freaking feel like doing it. But like I said, that was the two Alexanders, guys. Yeah, pain in the rear. And yeah, that can happen. And when you get in there in a room full with a little brat like that, there ain't nothing that's gonna stop them from, oh, I'm out DPSing you, I'm out doing this, I'm out doing that. There ain't nothing that's gonna stop their mouth. There ain't nothing gonna stop their little mouth, because they're just little brats on here chit-chatting and talking and being douchebags. And you don't want douchebags. So you're out DPSing somebody. What does it matter? It doesn't matter. Suck on an egg and be happy you're doing something. Don't talk. Shut up. That's one of the reasons is that you can loot, you can drop real quick if somebody, if someone says, oh, you're this, you're that. You're doing this, you're doing that, you're doing this wrong. If someone starts running, telling you how to run your character, tell them to shut up. They don't know how to run that character any more than you do. This allows you to reset your skills. Now, I'm gonna get out of this duty and reset my skills. Because apparently I'm not doing enough damage. So if you guys ever seen one of these, it allows you to reset your skills. Not your skills, but... This right here. Allows you to reset those. As a monk, you want this strength to be as high as possible. Vitality to be as high as possible. And you really don't need range, but I always put one in range. And there it goes. That winds up to be that. Now I'm going to queue up. What's vitality? I guess you guys are wondering. This is what it does. Affects physical melee damage. A monk, what a monk needs. This is dexterity. Affects physical range damage, melee damage dealt by rogues and ninjas. Vitality affects maximum health. Your health goes up. Okay, now we go and we start this. Hopefully I can get this done right this time. We won't run into any noobs and snobs and punks and whiners. Now you got a pumpkin head. Some of these people got some really cool names. Marley Misty Moon, that's pretty cool. And there's people with Yumi Sasuke Lost. Mindy Sauce. See, some of the names are pretty cool. And there's Redneck Girl. No comment. Like I said, there's some pretty cool names and there's some pretty lame names. Some of them really think them out, like this one I hear. And then there's Redneck Girl back there that doesn't think out their name. Okay, the LGBTS, lesbian, gays, and bisexuals, I guess. And some really think about how their character looks. She looks pretty tight. I'm hoping I can get in there soon. I really don't want to wait too long. Alright, this is going to be a brief cut, guys. Be right back. Alright. Like I said... And we're back. Like I said, there was going to be a brief cut, and there was. I had to check to see if my battery was still charging, which it is. I'm a controller, so I'm having to set in a funny way. like I said, some people put names, good names on their character. I mean, like that one. And there are some people, like that one, that you wonder why they even name their character. And then there's characters like this one. Nice name. And then there's characters like this one. And you wonder why. I don't think this is legible. No, it's not. But look at the detail on some of these characters. These are NPCs. Pretty cool detail. I just don't like the adder's hat. That thing looks kind of goofy. Costume's all yellow. I'm not a fan of yellow. I hate yellow. But look at that's company seal right there. That's the adder seal right there. See, she might have got that from here. And this chick. Is wearing a swimsuit. That's from this year, I think. But she's got the match. It looks pretty cool. Got it all glammed out. And I bet you pretty seriously, she's probably a high level. Yeah, she's level 60. She's got her level 200 gear. Wow. All of it. I don't know why she wouldn't wear this. Some of the... She's got 190 gear here, too. That's 200. Oh, here we go. There we are, guys. Hopefully, I can get this one done, and I can get up off here, and you guys can get... probably get tired of my voice and not seeing my face. Well, I do other things. So, yeah, my voice is just a thing that I have that I use. Why ain't I able to get out of third person? Ugh. Good, feed me. Let me hold me. It's the pain in the butt. Yeah, everybody's already started this. Oh, it's okay. So this boss is pretty much cut and dry. Always charge up Bin Tracker if you're going up against a boss like this guy. And let's do this, tank. Where you at? One of the tanks waits so long. This. Too much later. This is what happens when a group weld on machine. They don't have to say or any who gets what, they just do it. Does that mean you gotta break away from it? Does that mean you're setting buttons for nothing? The other tank is keeping him away from him. If not, they will do a charge up attack and you will be all hit. Need to break that little thing there. That is causing a ton of damage that we didn't need. But, come on. We can't take that damage. Alright, good. That reduced the damage. Not by a ton, but by enough. How you want it to go, you want it to go smoothly. I'm a midget. I I really sure missed it. I don't know what the status effect is. Am I doing half? Because I'm half my size. I'm really hoofing it though. I think it's like, there we go, I'm back to normal. And nothing I can do about that, but that's what it's supposed to do, is that I guess it's supposed to make you half your size. You're hoofing it like nobody's business. Like, oh crap, I'm hoofing it. I know one of these suckers is down. He's down. That had to go. It's done. Oh, that's cool. Need on everything, like I said. Unless I don't need any more of the. Unless you don't need it. Oh, sweet. I got something. Alright, well, guys, it is 9:12. It took a little bit longer than I wanted it to take. I thought it was gonna be over quick. It wasn't as quick as I thought it was gonna be, but hey, we got them done, you know. We got it done, and I'm gonna repair up, and I'm gonna go to Idleshire. If you guys want to continue watching this, you can. I'm gonna continue to have it up until I'm done with the repairing up and whatnot. And I guess I'll just directly work to Idleshire from where I don't know why I worked to Ogodinia. I need to go to Idleshire, see if I got something. See if I got something. 190. Repair up there, and I'll be good. Guys, if you want to know about the little gling, you can't get rid of those. I mean, I've tried deleting, you know, blocking them. I blocked 5 or 6 dozen of them, and they still keep popping up. Square Enix allows these people to advertise because they're making some money off of it, from what I understand. I'm wishing they'd get rid of these because it's real annoying for new players. They click on it, and they're like... That actually is the samurai rank. Cool. Asking her where she got it. There she is. Ha ha. Big fan. I'm a big fan of the character. Okay, well, I can get these hands for the monk. Pants is what. Boots, already got the boots. I'll get the gloves. I'm working up my 200 gear, but 190 will work for now. The bracelet, but I ain't got the bracelet. I ain't got the earlings with the bracelet yet. Screws. I got one. Not a big fan of the way they look. I gotta send my glamour for when I get the 200 gear. I might keep the 200 gear because they look pretty cool, the gloves of the 200 gear. Well, guys, like I said, I guess she's bound to duty. I guess they look alright. I'm not a big fan of the freaking armor crap on it, though. But, yeah, like I said, guys, I'm gonna stop the stream here, and I'll see you guys next time I stream on the next Grim Streams.